your TikTok, what? Upgrade your Instagram stories, your Instagram posts, your TikToks, your Tic Tacs, and all the things that make your photos lit. The kids still say lit these days. I don't even know what's going on. What's up, everybody? This is Scott. Welcome back to another video. In today's video, because of the Worldwide Developers Conference, or whatever WWDC stands for Apple, I'm going to give you my top five favorite photo and video apps that I use on my iPhone today. These apps are in no particular order, and they're all stupid easy to use. And honestly, that's perfect for me because I'm not the smartest person in the world. So let's just jump right into it and start. The very first one is this Focus app on the App Store. Focus is this really big computational photography type app. And you hear me a lot talk about computational photography on our live shows Wednesdays at 8 p.m. It gives you this DSLR-like photography and videography experience that you can use on your iPhone or your iPad Pro. You can get that creamy bokeh or the blurry background that they all like. Thanks for interrupting me, my Mac. You can adjust the depth of field on any photo that you take, and that includes any photo that you take outside of the app as well. A very easy UI to use, tons of different options that are out there. You can refocus your portrait shots that you've already taken, and it is a full computational photographer's dreamland inside the app. The app is free on the App Store and has in-app purchases, of course, so go check it out. Link in the description below for all the apps that I'm going to talk about. Next up, the next two actually are from our friends at Moment. One is the regular Moment app, which I'll talk about, but this very first one is the 60-second video app called Retro. Capture those delicious 60-second Instagram or TikTok videos where you use a lot of the vintage filters that our Moment team has put together and a lot of friends for Moment as well. Vintage is definitely in, so you can create and select from a bunch of pre-made lenses, make looks by changing on the fly by swiping left and right for different looks, change the frame rates, change real-time tracking, and all this other information. So yeah, your Instagram stories make a huge upgrade by using this app, and it's also free on the App Store. It does have in-app purchases, of course, but a lot of these apps are free, so you can go out and test them. The Retro app is really, really cool, but the Moment Official Pro app is even cooler. Now, this app is $5, so it's $4.99 right now on the App Store, and it allows you to make tons of manual changes like white balance and shutter and ISO and a really clean UI to do it. For filmmakers, it gives you all the features that you need and the ones that you don't, meaning color profiles, bit rates, real-time waveforms. For photographers, it's like shooting with a DSLR without having to actually buy a DSLR. Why go buy one when you effectively have as good of one, if not better in some cases, already in your pocket? There's also some amazing and awesomely cheap in-app purchases that you can make that gives you these light trails and time lapses. And it, yeah, overall, it's a really simple app. Absolutely love using it. So it really just depends on the flavor that I'm going for between the last two apps. Next up is the shockingly easy one to use called Spark Camera and Video Editor. This was actually one of Apple's 2019 best apps. And I'll be honest with you, I had never heard of it until I randomly stumbled across it. You can get really interesting TikTok or Instagram or story videos that you can make, and it is a dumb simple UI. It is perfect for me. It's a literally press and hold, record a thing, let go to the next area that you're trying to capture, press and hold it again, and it stitches all of that together. And you can also edit those videos after you capture them. It is a ridiculously easy app to use. You can capture things in 4K, multicam, you can add music and voiceovers and all this amazing stuff, and it's free on the App Store with, again, in-app purchases. You're kind of picking up what a lot of these people are doing. They're enticing you in with the free app, and then once you see how awesome it is, and Spark Cam is no different, you might make a couple purchases for those in-app things. Next up is from our friends over at Filmic Pro, which makes a great app, but they make a really good one so you can fully utilize both the front-facing and all the rear-facing cameras you have on your iPhone 11. And that app is called Double Take. You might recognize this app from September of 2019's Apple keynote, when there was somebody on stage shooting multiple angles at the exact same time, just using one iPhone. And that is exactly what this app is for. This app is nothing more than simultaneously capturing multiple angles of all of the lenses that you have at the exact same time. That's it. No other bells and whistles. It allows you to capture all that information at the exact same time. That's it. It's amazing. It's free. Go check it out in the App Store. Absolutely love it. So I have a bonus one that I did not know about until just a few days ago from Matty Hipoja on his channel, specifically talked about this app called Protake. Now, Matty actually comes out and says that he doesn't like any apps out there on the App Store like I've just talked about. He has the opposite addiction problem of mine, but he said that Protake was so good he had to give it a shot. So the app is free in-app purchases, and I bought the in-app purchases because I can't help myself. So Protake offers a lot of the same stuff that some of these apps talk about, but the UI just looks that much better. The experience using the app for me was just so much cleaner than a lot of apps that are out there. You can completely customize the capture experience, ISO, white balance, shutter speed. You can add filters. You have a beauty mode in there where you can, in real time, change the way that you look through, again, the power of kind of computational photography and videography inside the app as you're recording the video. All done, very easy to understand. I had no issues at all going into Protake and learning on the fly as I was recording. So I've actually recorded a few little demos with it, not inside of this video, but I've used it and it is super easy to use, goes straight to my photo album, and then I can kind of just airdrop it or share it with whomever. The app is just that easy to use. So that's it, that's my top five, actually a sixth bonus one of the video and photo apps that you should be using to up your game today and stay lit, my friends. So that's it, that's all I have. As always, like, share, subscribe, thumbs up, leave a comment below, and we'll see you next time.